Hey everyone, hope you all are fine. So we are just continuing our topic, that is interest on drawings. And even I told you that there are two methods to calculate interest on drawings. One we have discussed earlier in my previous video, that is product method. And today we are going to discuss the second method of calculation of interest on drawings, that is average period method. Now which method out of these two you have to opt, it depends upon the situation. So what are those conditions? If the amount of drawings is uniform and the time interval between two drawings is also uniform, then we have to use average period method in order to calculate interest on drawings. What these two statements says, for example, if Mr. Mohan is a partner who is withdrawing 5000 rupees at the beginning of each month, right? If he is withdrawing rupees 5000 in the beginning of each month, it means see, the amount is uniform, 5000 he is withdrawing, and the time interval is also uniform, means at the end of every month, at the last date of every month, the partner is withdrawing the money. So let's see how to calculate interest on drawing by following average profit period method. That is, interest on drawing IOD is equals to total drawings into rate upon 100 into average period upon 12. Now total drawings, how you will calculate? If the drawings are given monthly, then you have to multiply the given amount of drawing with 12, you will get total drawings. If the drawings are given half yearly, then you have to multiply it by 2, right? If it is given yearly, then there is no need to multiply the total amount as it is, you will take as total drawings. If it is given quarterly, then you have to multiply the amount with 4. So it depends upon the situation, right? Ki kaun se drawings hume given hai. So in order to make it total drawings, जो भी हमारे पास पीरियड होगा उसके अकॉर्डिंग हम उसको क्या कर लेंगे, मल्टीप्लाई कर देंगे इन ऑर्डर टू मेक इट एनुअल ड्रॉइंग्स. राइट, नाउ टोटल ड्रॉइंग्स वी कैन गेट इजिली, इट विल बी गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन, रेट विल बी गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन, राइट, लाइक विद व्हाट परसेंटेज वी हैव टू डिवाइड ऑन द टोटल ड्रॉइंग्स. नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज दिस एपी, व्हाट इज दिस एपी? एपी स्टैंड्स फॉर एवरेज पीरियड. Now how to calculate this average period? So we have to follow a formula, that is months left after first drawing plus months left after last drawing divided by 2. So this is how we will get average period. We just have to count the month left after first drawing. For example, there are conditions actually. So conditions or situations, you can say that. So whenever a different situation will come, so according to that we have to apply this average period formula. Now what are those situations? Let's discuss one by one. So the first situation or first case may be case number 1, when a partner withdraws 31st of March. If a partner is withdrawing on 1st April, then how many months are left up to 31st free? That is 12. And if he will withdraw at the last month in the beginning, then we will be having 1 month. It will be divided by 2. This is 13.2. It is 6.5. So average period will be taken 6.5. Is that okay? So what we have to do, जो पार्टनर
जिस भी मंथ के अगर वो बिगनिंग में मनी निकलवाएगा तो वी जस्ट हैव व्हाट वी हैव टू डू, आप लोगों को उस मंथ से लेकर लास्ट ईयर एंड तक के मंथ्स को देख लेना है, ठीक है। प्लस वो लास्ट मंथ कौन से पीरियड में निकलवाएगा, अगर वो बिगनिंग में पैसा विड्रॉ कराता है देन वी विल बी हैविंग अ होल मंथ, सो दैट इज व्हाई आई हैव टेकन वन। नाउ टेक अनदर सिचुएशन, व्हेन अ पार्टनर विड्रॉज एट द एंड ऑफ एवरी मंथ। नाउ सी वी आर हैविंग 12 मंथ्स, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12। इफ अ पार्टनर इज विड्रॉइंग एट द एंड, एंड मीन्स ही इज विड्रॉइंग on 30th of April, then how many months we are having? 11. Or at the last also he will withdraw at 31st, so at last we will be having no months, so 2, it is 5.5. is that fine? So this is how you have to consider the months in order to calculate average period. So we are having in total 5 to 6 situations. So 2 we have discussed, the next 3 we will discuss in our next video. So do practice, work hard.